Welcome to our special show, Future Generali, India Insurance and NDTV present Health Inside Out. Now in October 2020, the World Health Organization estimated that about 7.5% Indians suffer from some mental disorder and even predicted that by the end of the year, this could rise to 20%. Now the prolonged pandemic, the second wave, the lockdown, as well as the economic stress has severely impacted mental health, from depression to anxiety to more serious forms of mental illness. It's vital to get Indians to take their mental health seriously and remove the stigma in talking about it. So on this show today, we're going to highlight why this is so important. We're joined by Anoop Rao, MD and CEO, Future Generali India Insurance, Dr. Nimesh Desai, Director, IHBAS and Professor of Psychiatry, IHBAS. Also, Dr. Matthew Verghi, Senior Professor of Psychiatry at NIMHANS, and will also be joined by actor Shilpa Shetty. Mr. Anoop Rao, I'd like to start with you. What made Future Generali India Insurance include mental health in its insurance cover along with physical health?
So I think what really precipitated this for us was COVID, and we saw impact of mental health at our workspace, right? I mean, you see physical manifestations of it. You see shoulder pains, you see fatigue, you see frequent illnesses, so on and so forth. But what COVID-19 really brought to the fore was also, what I would call the social dimension, people's inability to meet other people, you know, participate in teamwork, engage with other individuals. And we have some experts on the panel today, but then they would tell you that man's a social animal and nobody really wants to be lonely at work. But that's what you're all grappling with, right? I mean, so for the period when we were locked down and then, you know, people could visit office very infrequently, people lacked that larger net or the safety net which you got through interactions with other people. Besides that, there were pressures at work which you were anyway carrying home on a regular basis. On top of that, you saw a lot of our employees actually going home, and then the space between the personal and professional space completely got blurred. So mental wellness and illness have been issues we have struggled with for a long time, and I think we have been oblivious to it, or even if it was evident, we decided to ignore it. What we decided to do at Future Generali was to use this opportunity and get a conversation going around it, and then so that people can start talking about it. Also, we discovered that most companies, insurance companies, only covered hospitalization for mental illness. They didn't cover counseling, and only in 1% of the cases did the patient actually require hospitalization. And we thought that was an area which we, you know, needed to cover. So you went ahead and launched a plan which was radically different from what the rest of the industry was offering.
And that's so important to get that conversation going around it. Shilpa Shetty, if you could talk about this, the need to create more awareness, to talk more about mental health.
Oh my God, I can't seem to emphasize more on it, especially in these times where literally in unprecedented times. And this is when we need to focus more on our mental health than even our physical health. While we talk about, I know when people see me do yoga, they think it's more for body, but I really believe that mental health has definitely taken precedence for me, even for me. I just feel that with the pandemic, there's been so much anxiety, and then the lockdown has made it even worse. We've lost jobs, we've lost friends, we've lost family. Some of them haven't even been able to mourn their family members. You know, I've had a friend who lost her mom, but she couldn't even go to the crematorium. So, I mean, even the sanest people can lose it. I had a situation in my home where I had 11 people falling sick with COVID at the same time. So you just undergo a gamut of emotions. And in these times, especially, you're seeing people working from home. It sounds very interesting and it sounds very comfortable, but people who have been working from home, you can definitely see that, you know, the line has been blurred between their personal and professional life. I feel people are working more from home. And marriages are going through such stress because I don't think husbands and wives have spent so much time with each other. I mean, on a lighter note. But so I can't emphasize more than a time like this to, you know, kind of dispel the myths, the stigma that mental health comes with. People who are struggling with it, they know it's lurking somewhere, and maybe they've, you know, brushed it under the carpet, but now more so it's going to, you know, erupt and it's going to be in their faces. So they really need to go and seek help.
Dr. Nimish Desai, I'd like to come to you. Not enough people in India are even aware of, you know, mental health issues, the symptoms either dismissed or then even hidden for fear of stigma attacks, or the person doesn't seek help. This is a huge challenge, isn't it?
Yes. If I got you right, our society has usually had a problem of lack of awareness about mental health issues as health conditions. Secondly, there has been a lot of stigma. Unfortunately, for human race and for large parts of human race, 2020 and 2021, almost everything that could go wrong has gone wrong. Fear of infection and death. In the recent second wave, actually a lot of losses due to death. Of course, the economic issues and the lockdown and the isolation and everything that goes with it. So the only silver lining of this terrible situation might be that we will, as a society and as communities, grow more aware about mental health issues, less stigmatized, if not remove the stigma, seek help, and more importantly, provide help. I'm always very fond of saying sharing is caring, but sharing and caring needs to be a bilateral or a multilateral process. There have been so many people around us who have suffered that if all of us can be open to people's suffering and pain, we can help each other, one, as human beings, as neighbors, as friends, as family, and identify those people who require professional help. For some section of the people, professional help is unavoidable if you want to reduce the possible suicide rates and the other morbidity and mortality. And so if there is any time, there was ever any time, this is the time for really galvanizing mental health awareness.
Right. And, you know, everybody has a right to seek it. And also, you know, it needs to be affordable. Dr. Matthew Varghese, your experience over this last year and also how every Indian has a right to mental health services.
Yeah. So I think what you said in the beginning about the number of people with mental disorders, already with our National Mental Health Survey, which NIMHANS coordinated for the Government of India, we had a prevalence of mental disorders of about 10%, which included all the disorders. And it's expected that with the pandemic, these rates of depression and anxiety might go up anything from 5 times to more. So depression and anxiety is going to be a serious problem. Together with that, we anticipate that there might be many more people who might attempt suicide or complete suicide. We anticipate that there might be many more people who have an alcohol or a substance use problem. But also remember that some of it might be a normal reaction of human beings to a very abnormal situation, because we must remember that we are actually in a disaster. So in disasters, anxiety, depression, and all these problems will increase. We also think that post-traumatic stress disorder, because of the trauma of being in the situation, is also going to increase. And that was not so much present earlier, but it's going to increase.
After listening to Dr. Matthews, Varghese, it's really a revelation, the numbers with the stats that he has given us. And imagine if those mental health figures are so high. In this pandemic, it's gone even higher. So maybe from 20 crore people who have already been suffering with mental illness, we have maybe 15 crore people who are now jobless. So it really makes the numbers rise up so much higher. And there's so many people who are jobless and are going to be like that for a long time. So, when you hear suicide cases on the rise, it's not surprising. It's appalling.
Right. So Anoop Rai, now providing this insurance cover for mental health care, what kind of an impact has this had, do you think, on destigmatizing the issue, also helping people get timely treatment for something they didn't want to acknowledge before this?
So I think we've just started the conversation. I mean, to be honest, I think we have just scratched the tip of the iceberg. But I think what really helped was that we got a lot of people to start talking about it, including Shilpa Shetty on our panel today. I mean, and in fact, she aced her mental health score. She did very well on both physical and mental health parameters. But one of the things we did was we got a lot of celebrity sportsmen, you know, your Chiteshwar Pujara and Robin Uthappa, who were very open with the fact that, you know, they had sought help. So I think the fact that a lot of people have started talking about it has made this, has taken that stigma away from the illness. I think Virat Kohli in the past too spoke about it. I think even at workplaces and even in society, a lot of people are now more willing to acknowledge the fact that they're probably suffering from some kind of depression or mental illness or they need help. So I think I would broadly fit this into three categories. One is that, you know, acknowledging there's a problem. And I think as a country, we've been very good all this while at denying there's a problem. You know, that mental stress or lack of mental wellness was something you were supposed to get over. You were supposed to be mentally tough to get over it. I mean, nobody recognized that, you know, you could require professional treatment or guidance. The second is that, you know, telling people after they acknowledge it is that, you know, to be able to go out and seek treatment for it and say that, look, I'm good to consult somebody because I'm not the expert. My family can provide me support, but they can't provide me professional guidance or advice. That's stage two. Stage three is obviously, you know, the fact that, you know, let's also acknowledge that, you know, be it workplace productivity or be it how well people are able to operate in society, it's a function of both your physical and mental health. And while organizations, you know, largely end up, you know, giving people day off, saying that the person's got a cough and a cold or fever, how many organizations actually, you know, take a leave application which says that, you know, that the guy says that or the person says that, look, I'm not feeling well, I'm not feeling up to it today, can I take a couple of days off? And I think there's very little acceptance of that. And I think that's the stage we need to get to finally.
It's so important to get, you know, celebrities and those that people look up to talk more so that it destigmatizes the issue. Dr. Desai, if you could talk about some of the challenges that, you know, you've seen in the last year or so due to COVID and the lockdowns, rise in addiction, relapsing, you know, people having suicidal ideation, depression due to isolation, and a lot of people having just existential worries in this last year.
A few challenges, yes, Gargi. One, for people who are already suffering with mental illnesses or mental health problems, those persons with mental illness and their families have had a very difficult time accessing mental health services. The second is that people with mental health problems, as and when they develop COVID positive status, during the COVID positive status and after recovery, there is, of course, the problem of their hospitalization in any place. Let's accept that in this 1 year or 14 months, we have still not seen the system's stigma about mental health, persons with mental health problems reduce significantly, despite best efforts. So there is, of course, that problem. The third is the hidden psychiatric mental health morbidity with COVID positive status and for those who have lost near and dear ones. Now there is beginning to be an effort, and that will need to be so much more for the survivors of those who fell to COVID and or those who came out after a lot of arduous ventilatory or ICU support, their mental health problems, we really need to have more outreach programs.
Shilpa Shetty, if you could talk about how do you deal with stress, if you could share with us, you know, about mental well-being through meditation and yoga?
I deal with it. I think I'm able to deal with it because I've understood the science of yoga. And it happens after a very long period of sadhana. For me, yoga is not just, you know, not just a regime. It's become my lifestyle. I practice it. I live it. So that concept, once people get their heads around the concept of yoga, it becomes far more easier because I really believe that you don't have control over what's going to happen to you. You don't have control on the future. What you do have control on is yourself, your mind. And that's why they say pran ayam. Pran pe ayam hona bahut zaruri hai. And I think with my sadhana, I have realized that if I can't control the exterior, I can definitely control what's going inside and within me. And that happens with control over breath, pran ayam.
All right, with that, time for us to slip into a short break. We'll return with more. Do keep watching. Welcome back to our special show, Future Generali. India Insurance and NDTV present Health inside out. Well, let's go back to Anoop Rao for more. And one of the things that were quite an eye-opener during our research was reading about your total health score that assesses the state of one's mental well-being and how many of the influencers who took this test were less than 100% when they thought that, you know, everything was just fine. So tell us about that.
So, you know, Gargi, in case I want to do my blood works or my ECG or I want to get my heart checked, you know, I can walk into a laboratory, I mean, or to a path center or to a hospital and get myself tested. Unfortunately, you know, it's not that common to get your mental health score. So how well you are feeling, how good you are mentally, is something we don't measure. So the idea was to get an API-based tool where people can actually, you know, answer a few questions and they get an indication of how mentally, how they fare. So yes, it was quite an eye-opener for not just the celebrities, but for a lot of us, that when we realized that we were not 100% mentally fit, whereas we could be 100% physically fit. As I mentioned earlier, Shilpa Shetty was an exception. She scored extremely well, both in her mental and physical fitness score. But the idea, again, was to start a conversation, Gargi. It was to, you know, ask people to start taking this test and kind of do a bit of self-examination, introspection, and understand where exactly they stand as far as their mental fitness is concerned or wellness is concerned. So over 300,000 people have taken this test at this point in time, and we've got compliments from a lot of people on the way it's been designed. So based on what the result throws out, you know, we give people access to a repository of knowledge and literature where they can read up on their condition. But we always advise people to seek guidance and advice from a professional.
All right, so let's ask Shilpa about that. Shilpa, tell us about taking the total health score. You did very well, as Anoop said, but was there anything that surprised you, anything that, you know, made you think twice?
Yes, I think Anoop had a hand in doing that. I was really surprised that I only scored 80. I need to do that test again. But I take it in my stride. I think there's always scope for improvement. And I think there's, you need to understand that just because you're working out and just because, you know, you're in the public eye and you're looking happy doesn't mean that everything is perfect. We need to take some time off and to, you know, reflect on who we are within, what is happening, what is going on. We're not, I feel that we don't have the time to do that. I feel everything else has taken precedence. So, you know, what I really love, what Giranda ji had written for you, he said, disease is when your body and mind is, when your body and mind is not at ease, it causes diseases. And I feel the biggest disease right now is the fact that we are also anxious. It truly is it's a mental disorder that we are not able to, and these are abnormal circumstances. We are not able to think rationally in even normal circumstances. So this is an abnormal circumstance. So for times like this, I really feel that when you do a test like that and you realize that the stats are pretty low, there's still scope for improvement. Still above average, 80 is not bad. But it makes me realize that I need to maybe breathe more. I maybe need to make sure that in my position, if I can play a catalyst and make a difference to even one life, maybe through your platform, I'm more than happy to do that. And kudos to Future Generali, who has actually brought mental illness to the forefront, you know. And insurance is not just about health, but also about mental health.
Right. Dr. Matthew Varghese, now to you, if you could, you know, talk to us about what policy changes you think should be brought about to deal with this issue of mental stress, mental ill health. What steps do you think are needed in India right now?
We have the Mental Health Care Act, which mandates that everybody who is a citizen of India should get care, especially mental health care. We also have the National Mental Health Program, which is actually now covering almost all the 500 or 600 districts in the country. So with these programs and these policy changes and the Act, we think that India will be, you know, able to take care of this, you know, large number of people who have mental disorders. Now, we also have to look at this, what is called as the WHO pyramid of care. So if you take a pyramid, and at the bottom of the pyramid are things that all of us can do for ourselves. As you heard Ms. Shetty talk about what she did for self-care, that is something, you know, doing exercise, meditating, you know, taking care of your health, you know, taking care of the illnesses that you have. These are all things that we can do for self-care. And self-care is low-tech and low-cost, but it's necessary for the large amount of population of people. And if you do self-care, you can actually prevent diseases like depression, anxiety, and many of the other physical illnesses like heart disease, diabetes, and so on. At the top of the pyramid is going to a psychiatrist or getting admitted or, you know, meeting counselors. That is going to cost money, and I'm happy that insurance companies will start paying for these.
Dr. Desai, if you could just elaborate on that a bit more. It's important for people to understand that, you know, just as the body falls ill, so does the mind.
Oh, absolutely, Gagi. Indeed, a tad more important, because the brain is the CPU, the hardware, and the mind or the mental functions is the software of that CPU. And so a lot of physical health actually will also depend on the psychological state and the mental health. And so physical and mental health are so intertwined that mental health needs to be actually recognized as a tad more important.
Right. Anoop Rao, if you could tell us, you know, more about Future Generali's other initiatives to raise awareness around mental health, which is something that's clearly very, very needed.
So we did, one of the things we wanted to do was to get a lot of celebrities to talk about it. The other was to, our ad campaign is focused on dealing with this with empathy and humor. So, you know, we have used inanimate objects to talk about mental wellness from their perspective. So a stress ball which is torn, a cap which is chewed off, a pen cap which is chewed off, a pillow which has been wept upon, so on and so forth. I think what we are really encouraging through social media and other mediums is conversations. And I believe, and we believe, that once you start having the conversations, I think the outcomes and results will follow. Conversations will lead to action, and action will lead to consequences which are positive. That's what Future Generali intends doing.
All right. Well, thank you so much all for joining us, Anoop, Shilpa, and doctors for joining us on this show. So clearly it's vital to get Indians to take mental health seriously and remove the stigma in talking about it. Thank you for watching. Goodbye. Thank you.